morning everyone. In this video, I'm going to explain class 12 CBSE poem Keeping Quiet, composed by Pablo Naruda. So before I start this poem, I just want to tell you about the poet Pablo Neruda. So Pablo Neruda was born on 12th July 1904 in Chile and died on 23rd September 1973. And he was awarded with the Nobel Prize, which is given in the field of literature. So he was awarded with the Nobel Prize in 1971. And apart from it, he was awarded with the Lenin Peace Prize. And basically, this poem, Keeping Quiet, is written in Spanish language. And later on, it was translated in all the different languages. So this present, his style of writing is very simple and easy to understand. So let's come to the poem. So what does basically this poem tells? So through this poem, Pablo Neruda, advocated the virtue of silence in the form of introspection and meditation. Nowadays, as you know, this is the very fast-pacing life. And so in fast-pacing life, the people are very much stressed, suffering with hypertension, and because of the nature of job, because there is too much competition, and the people are becoming of materialistic nature. They want to earn more and more. People are becoming greedy. So all these things bringing sadness to our life. So poet here are advocating to keep quiet for some time. He's requesting all the people of the world to spare some time to think so that they could get the peace of mind. So let's start this poem. And the first stanza, the poet says, now we will count up to 12 and we will all keep still. So the poet is saying that he would count up to 12 in he's requesting to people to meditate and to keep quiet. These 12 numbers represents the 12 hours of the day or the 12 months of a year. So here the poet asks to all the people to remain calm and composed and sit in meditation or in introspection. So when they will sit in meditation position or they will introspection position, so it would bring peace to them. So here the poet is requesting, for once on the face of earth, let's not speak in any language. The poet is saying, when you will sit in this meditation position, so you will not speak in any language of the world, because this language divides the people. Rather than bringing close to each other, it divides the people. So let's not stop for 1 second and not move our arms so much. He's saying you have to sit in a still position. You don't need to move your arms. Arms here also symbolizes the weapon which the different countries are making to spread their territory. Fine. So when the poet is saying, when you will sit in that meditation, so you will reach to an exotic moment. So you will be away from all the tensions of life. There would be no hurry. There would be no sound of engines. We are leading a mechanic life. We get up early in the morning with the sound of clock. We get up and then throughout the way we keep on running. When you will sit in that meditation position and introspect, so all we will get the peace of mind. And in that state of meditation, in that state of introspection, people will different people what they would realize. Like the fisherman in the cold sea, the fisherman who have engaged, who have spent their whole life in killing the whales, who goes in deep sea and they kill the whales. And in that state of meditation, they will come to know that what harm they are causing to the environment. They are playing with the ecosystem. Just for greed, they are killing the whales. So they would realize this is not good for the ecosystem. And not only the fishermen, you know, those salt gatherers, they would also realize they will also get time to see, to look towards their hands, because throughout their life they were busy in collecting the salts. They did not get time to look towards their hurted hands. So now they would get time to look towards their hands. And not only these, people, those who prepare the chemical weapons, scientists, so they will also get time to ponder, to think, you know, why they are making these harmful weapons. So they would realize their mistakes, because nowadays different countries make weapons just to, you know, defeat the another country. So they make chemical weapons. Nowadays the war is fought because of fought with the gas, with the fire, and the, these, you know, scientists would realize what is the use of victory when there is no survivor left on both the sides. You know, people would, children would become, you know, orphaned this side also and the other side also. There is no use. What is the use of that victory when there is no one left to enjoy that victory? So in that state of meditation, you know, soldiers of both the sides would realize that war is not the solution of any problem. So they would come together and they would sit, they would change their clothes, they would put on clean clothes, and they would sit together under the shade of the tree, and they would discuss the problem, and they would realize that war is not the solution. Solution can come through the talks. Yes, and here the poet, next stranger, the poet says that he should not be, you know, taken in wrong way. He's not advocating to become lazy or inactive. So where he's saying, he's just saying to sit in meditation and introspect. He's not advocating inactivity. He's not saying that people should stop working and sit idly. So he's saying, my words should not be taken in another way. He says, they should work throughout their life, because their needs will be fulfilled by doing work only. And then he says that, people are continuously work to achieve their tasks without even thinking about their results. So they are in constant fear of death, and therefore they want to achieve most of the things before their death. So the poet requests people to stop for a while and take some time to think, you know, what they have earned until now, and you know, they should enjoy that. And when they will think, when they will ponder it, so this would remove their sadness. So the poet says, we can learn, you know, this too much stress. You know, people are thinking about their death. When they are coming, when they come in any problem, they start thinking about the easy way. They find, you know, committing suicide and thinking negatively will solve their problem. So the poet says that you can learn from the earth. So what we can learn from the earth? To be patient. He says, you know, nature. He gives the example of nature. He says, during winter season, everything freezes. You know, everything becomes lifeless. You know, there is a depressing environment because all the water bodies, you know, freezes. You know, trees, you know, shed their all leaves. You know, there is a very dull and depressing environment. But after that, spring comes and everything comes to life. Bird starts chirping, you know, a new leaves come on the trees, you know, flower blossoms. So this keeps on, the bad time and the good time keeps on coming in the life of the people. So when the tough time, you should not be disappointed. So we can learn from the earth. So in that state of mind, and whenever the problem comes. So he says that solution is with you. You should sit and should sit and introspect. When you introspect, so you can get the solution of your problem, because nowadays the people are stressed, so they go to psychiatrists to get their solution of their problems, so that they can find the solution of their problems themselves. When they will sit and think, they will get the solution. So finally he ends up his poem by saying that I will count up to 12 and you keep quiet and I will go. So he said he would sit, he again counts up to 12 and he says I will go. He says that he has conveyed his message, he has given his message to the people, and he wants them to think over it, and it will work in the direction of peace. When people will think, they will come closer to each other, and this thought will bring brotherhood, universal peace to them. So children, this was the poem Keeping Quiet. Hope you liked my video, and if you like, please like and subscribe to it. Thank you so much.